If you're dealing with hair loss or hair thinning, then in this video, we're going to dive deep into the world of shampoos and what actually works to stop and reduce hair loss and improve hair regrowth. We're diving into the science, so let's go straight into it. Now, before we jump into the shampoos, it's important to note that healthy hair starts with a healthy scalp. The way I like to think of it is your scalp is like the soil that helps the garden grow, and the hair is basically the plants growing from that soil. We need the most healthy soil that isn't inflamed, that is as nutritious as possible for our hair to grow. So, commonly seen in patients with androgenic alopecia, male or female pattern baldness, some of the things that make things worse are an inflammation of the scalp, clogged pores, poor circulation. All of these can make the situation far, far worse. So this is regardless of the shampoo first. I want to discuss the health of your scalp first, because I have seen so many patients of mine who come in who are suffering with hair loss and thinning of the hair, who are avoidant of brushing their hair or avoidant of going to the shower and washing their hair. They'll just wash their body and just do everything they can not to touch their hair because they don't want to see the hair fall. They don't want to see the shedding. They don't want to see it on the towel. They don't want to see it on the bottom of the bath or shower. And I completely understand that. But you need to understand that if the destiny of that hair follicle was to fall, no matter what you do, no matter even if you use all the treatments and shampoos and everything I'm going to discuss about in this video, it's not going to make a difference because that hair follicle was going to fall. What's important is we're thinking about the remaining hair follicles that are still healthy. We need to give them the nutrition from the soil, i.e. the scalp. So do a 5 to 10 minute head massage every single day. If you can, do it before you go for a shower as well. Do it before you use any of the shampoos that we discuss in this video. By doing that, we're going to get that blood circulation on our head. So we're going to get a better effect from the actual shampoos or treatments that you use as well. So the head massage is key to everything else we talk about. This is the foundation, and now we're going to build on it. So next up, let's talk about ketoconazole shampoo. You may have heard of it. It's often given in patients who have dandruff, which is caused by a fungus. So ketoconazole is part of the imidazole family. And nervous, it ends in azole. So if you ever see drugs with that kind of name, there might be an antifungal medication. So it's really effective at getting rid of fungus, which is going to be really useful for keeping our scalp nice and healthy, giving the best environment for our hair follicles. As a result of that, it reduces inflammation in the area as well. Now, another benefit of ketoconazole as well is it actually has an effect on DHT, dihydrotestosterone, and it can be really helpful at blocking the effects of that. The effects of DHT we see in androgenic alopecia, which causes hair loss. So it basically affects the follicle and causes more hair loss. It reduces the growth phase and increases our shedding phase and causes what we usually see with hair loss caused by androgenic alopecia. Now, one thing that's really important with ketoconazole, because I have had many patients come to me, especially when I give it for dandruff, for example, so you know the effects are seen a lot quicker for that, telling me that it hasn't been affected. When I ask the patients, how did you use it? 9 times out of 10, they tell me that they used it like a normal shampoo. They just put it in, got as much foam as possible, rubbed it along their hair, on the strands of hair, and then washed it out. If you are doing that, you won't get the full effects of ketoconazole. What you need to do is you need to rub it in gently and nicely into your scalp, all over, evenly spread, and leave it in there for at least 3 to 5 minutes. That is the magic number, and you need to do that so it can have its effect. If you're not doing that, it's not going to be affected, and you're going to be like my patient who didn't see much benefit in it. Again, you need to give it time. Also, remember, ketoconazole, you should ideally use it maybe 2 to 3 times a week. Sometimes you might have to use it a bit less because it can be quite irritating for some patients. But the most important thing is you're using it correctly. And once you've used the ketoconazole, make sure to use a conditioner afterwards just to help keep the moisture and hydration in the hair. So next up, let's talk about caffeinated shampoos. Yes, it's not just in the coffee that we like to drink in the morning. Shampoos can contain caffeine in them, and they can actually be quite helpful for the hair growth and hair loss as well. Why? Well, caffeine has a vasodilator effect, so it means it improves blood flow towards the scalp, which basically is going to nourish those hair follicles more. It can help lengthen the growth phase as well of the hair follicles, which again is going to help with our regrowth and hair loss, so reducing hair shedding. And it can also block some of the effect of DHT, kind of similar to how we spoke about ketoconazole before and its effect, has a similar effect, a little less mild compared to ketoconazole, but it still does have some effect on DHT. So all of this is really going to help with that hair growth and reducing hair loss and hair shedding. Now, one thing to bear in mind as well, again, I keep going on about this, but it's all about using these shampoos correctly. You can use caffeinated shampoos 3-4 times a week. You can even use it daily use as well. But again, remember to massage it in nicely into the scalp. We're not, you know, talking about just placing it on the hair follicles themselves, but, you know, massage it in nicely and let it do its work on the scalp, because that scalp is like the soil that nourishes the hair, okay? Remember again, after using a caffeinated shampoo, for example, always condition the hair as well to keep it healthy. And next up, let's talk about zinc pyrithione. Very difficult to pronounce, but this is an ingredient that you'll see in some shampoos that are marketed for anti-dandruff activity, all right? The zinc is very good at increasing the skin cell turnover. So it's helping increase the cell turnover on our scalp, which is basically gonna give us a far healthier scalp and reduce inflammation, all right? Remember the soil analogy? This is quite good for that. Also, there are some studies showing that it helps block the effects of DHT to some extent. So again, it's going to be effective for that as well. Now, in terms of how often should you use a shampoo that contains zinc pyrithione, I'd recommend about 2-3 times a week. That's more than enough. It's going to have its effect then. Again, like I've always said, with all the different shampoos that we've spoke, rub it nicely into the scalp, evenly across everywhere, give it a bit of time to work, and then rinse it out. So follow up with a conditioner. That's just going to help keep things nice and soft and untangled, all right, and nice and moisturized as well. So it's always a good idea to follow up with a conditioner as well. Next up, let's talk about Scandinavian BioLab. I'm sure you've all heard of them and their Bio-Pilixin Serum, which is a non-medicated 100% vegan formula with plant-based ingredients inspired by nature. And it contains carefully selected ingredients like capilla longa. This is a natural active ingredient that helps improve hair density. Vanillyl butyl ether. This is a warming agent that creates a tingling sensation on the scalp, improving blood flow to the area and improving absorption. It also contains niacinamide. And these ingredients have been specifically chosen for their properties through scientific literature reviews. The Scandinavian BioLabs team are very good friends of the channel, and to learn more about their products and the science behind the formula, definitely do visit their website, link in the description below. Scandinavian BioLabs, thank you for being our trusted sponsor. So I think the key information now is, remember to summarize really, don't forget the scalp massaging, really, really important. Many studies out there supporting it. It's a natural way of helping improve blood circulation to the scalp. Remember, the scalp is like the soil, I keep saying this, and we need to nourish it and keep it as healthy as possible to improve hair growth and reduce our shedding as well. Also, the shampoos that we spoke about, ketoconazole, caffeinated shampoos, the zinc pyrithione, they're all good, but also you need to manage your expectations as well. You can't expect miracles overnight. It's not gonna all of a sudden, by using it, all your hair loss is gonna stop. Hair's all gonna regrow. So you really need to, you know, be consistent to help keep that scalp nice and healthy to get those effects. I had a patient a few months ago, actually, who was using caffeinated shampoos, and they didn't really see any benefit in it. They hadn't noticed any change at all. That's all they were doing. They were using it for a couple of months. So, you know, one thing that I told that patient was to be consistent and continue it, but also combine it with other treatments as well. So don't just think, that's it now, I'm on the shampoo and it's all going to stop, because most likely it might reduce, but it's not going to stop completely, and you're not going to get that much regrowth compared to treatment options as well, such as minoxidil, such as finasteride, which can be applied topically, as well as the low level laser helmets as well. They're really, really good. I prefer them over the wands, basically, because they're really hard to use. You know, you can put them on every single day and use them, and you get the photobiomodulation, which is really, really effective for hair loss as well. So it's all about combining them really and giving it time to work. So that's really what I mean by managing expectations. Don't expect overnight cures and stopping and all the hair growing back. Give it time and be consistent. And I know it's easier said than done, because no one likes to see their hair falling, but it can be really effective when they're all done together. So I really hope this information was helpful for you, and I really wish you the best with your hair loss journey. If you know anyone who will, you know, find this video helpful as well, please do share it with them. And I appreciate you watching this video. There's loads of videos on YouTube, but you chose to watch my video. And as I always say, sending awesome vibes, and I'll see you next week.